Hey, this is Phil Lilley, Lilley's Landing Resort and Marina on Lake Taneycomo. Jack and I are out doing one cast today. Hey, it's done. I have not been out at all today. It really hurt a whole lot, except this morning they said the shad bite, white jig bite, was pretty good early. And then they went to Scuds and did really good from here down to Trout Hollow. Table Rock is at 917.8 right now after the rain we got last night. So it's come up about 6 inches. And we have more rains and storms for tomorrow. So we're looking at this flow for a while. I'm not sure when the turbines will be fixed and they'll be back online where they can run 4 units. And when they run the 4 units, they won't have to run the floodgates. But I wanted to come back up here and just try the white jig for just a little bit. I did see some fish break the surface several times on the way up here, which usually means they're chasing shad, but I don't know. There's only 3 boats up here, 3 or 4. So that's not a real good sign, but there's one. I mean, you are going to catch fish up here right up the cable on white jig if you just spend all your time up here. Oh my gosh, you talk about a belly. Just I'll go ahead and do this. Sure, not looking right in that sun. I think I missed 2. Typically, you know, if they're not seeing a lot of shad, then they'll, oh God, that's 3 I've missed. You know, they'll bite pretty good for a ways and then, yeah, that's fine. I'm using a 3/32 ounce white jig. White and gray, actually. 4 pound line. Yeah, it's kind of crazy. They bite really good up there. There's one. He hit that one like he was looking for it. He's not that big, and he's not that fat. Come on. There was a southwest wind today at 12 to 15, and I did drive over the dam at Table Rock this afternoon, and I wanted to see, I think that might have been bottom. I wanted to see, okay, there's a shad swimming in the water right there, and there was a fish after it. There was just a single thread fin, and he was actually swimming. He was swimming through the foam, and there was a fish right behind it. Took a swipe at it. So there's shad coming through. Let's go to this side. So there you go. Not seeing any dead shad, but there is a live one right there. Swam right under the boat. Anyhow, the wind, I was hoping that it was coming in and just right up against the dam face, because shad will move. You know, they're in big schools, and wind will move shad, and the hope is to move those shad and push them right up against the dam face and then get sucked through the floodgates. So it's better than it was last night. Because I didn't get any bites down here yesterday. That was a short bite. Well. So they're hitting from the cable down to about outlet number 3. Okay, let's go back up. I'm gonna try black and white with a black head. It's a 3/32 ounce. I think Blake comes home tomorrow. Back to the real world. Dwayne on a trip. There's one. Took a little bit. Black and white worked. Boy, this one's a fighter too. Gosh. Nope, can't get him up. He's too fat. Oh, he's gone. Ooh, he wasn't that long. Maybe 17, but man, he was a tank. Should have netted him. This jig actually has a lot of black and not a lot of white in it. So I'm planning on, when I get down here another 200-300 yards, I'm gonna switch to a scud. Oh, I missed one. Dwayne's got the net out. I'm down to outlet 3. Give this just another few seconds. All right. We're gonna switch to a scud rig. Let's see. Okay, I've got, it's a double scud rig. Bell weight on the bottom, scud on a dropper. That's kind of an olive brown. And then I've got a gray peppy up here on the top. It's all 4-pound fluorocarbon tied on to 4-pound mono. I have not drifted a scud up here that much. Both of these are number 14. Well, here's a fish, finally. I was gonna say. Feels pretty good. But the others felt pretty good too, so I'm not gonna say. Amazing, these big fish hit this little tiny fly. Got a pretty good head shake. It is a rainbow. I saw that much.
Oh yeah, it's a big boat. Looks really broad. All right, guy, you're not gonna get me into the trees, are you? No, not too close. I don't think he's 20. He's just a big, beefy rainbow. He took the Peppy, the second fly, up the gray. Let's see if I can get him up. I just don't want to end up in the trees. All right, I'm gonna lip him. I'm still battling cuts on my fingers from the other day. Nice fish. And I'm not that close to the trees. Well, that was a nice one, wasn't it? He fought really, really good. He's probably 19. I'm going to go ahead and recast. Not getting on the bottom, so I'm going to have to point the boat up a little bit. Sorry. Oh, that sun's right in the camera. Still not where I'm supposed to be, though. Now I'm on the bottom. Thank you.
No, I'm not. It is hard to stay on the bottom in this stretch. Come on, fish. That was bottom. See if I can get on the bottom doing this. There we go. I'm still on the bottom. It is all that matters. just about down to Lookout Island, and that's where I'm gonna end it. I actually wanted to drift a scud through this section. I thought it'd be pretty good. In fact, I'm gonna move over just a little bit. I'm gonna drift on past the island. Just this stretch right through here is where I wanna drift. It's good flat gravel. Kind of bend it this way, you can see the island. And I drifted from Lookout down. Was it yesterday or day before? I don't know. But I caught two. Then I drifted from Fall Creek down to Trout Hollow and caught four on a scud. And days are running together. I did not stay connected to the bottom through there very good. All right. Got a nice rainbow. Got bit. Missed some bites. Fishing's still pretty good. Appreciate you watching. We'll see you tomorrow. Thanks. Well, down below Lookout is drifting a white jig over here close to the bank. Can't lift it. Could be 20.
took longer than the other one I caught.